Hello, everyone, and welcome to another episode of The Shit You Missed Today. Topics that may be important to some and not important as to others. I will be discussing a couple of juicy topics. Oh, man. Well, they're not really juicy, but, you know, there's topics that, you know, that are up in the air for discussions. Anyway. If you like any of my videos, click the like button, and if you want to subscribe, you're more than welcome to subscribe. Let's proceed. I got to get my pens and everything together. I'm gonna put that over there. Sorry. Get me some lotion on, cause I was in the shower, and I usually put on shea butter, but I put some on after I do this video. I'll put some on. Whatever. All right, let's get started with the first topic today. Put on my glasses. A cow was spotted waiting in the drive-through line at a Wisconsin McDonald's. I guess he was asking, where's the beef or where the fuck my friends at? Okay, let's read. It says, Jessica Nielsen was waiting in the McDonald's drive-thru line in Marshfield, Wisconsin, last Thursday when she realized something unusual about a fellow customer a few cars ahead of her. A cow is in the back seat. Oh, I thought this was like a cow actually walked through the drive-thru. The cow was in the back seat of somebody's car. That's when she took a camera phone to capture the scene, which she posted on Facebook. With the captions, a whole freaking cow? Tell me you live in Wisconsin without telling me you live in Wisconsin. I thought it was fake at first. Who puts a cow in a Buick? She told the Associated Press. It had to be a baby cow because I'm pretty sure. You know the size of a cow, and if you ever seen a Buick, especially if it's an old school like a Buick LaCrosse or a Buick LeSabre, you can't fit a fucking cow in there. Maybe a baby cow, but not a big cow. After all, what would a cow be doing at a fast food restaurant known for its beef burgers? I mean, I think the person who brought in the cow was very disrespectful. And then you getting a burger on top of that. So you basically saying, this is what happens to you when you act up or when we're hungry. Like, that's just so disrespectful to the cow. You gonna sit up there and bring a cow to a McDonald's restaurant to show what happened to him? And the cow just oblivious. He don't even know what's going on. He's just thinking he's just on a ride. I just thought that was a very funny topic to talk about. Because I'm just like, I was under the impression that the cow actually like walked through the drive-thru. You know, that's what I was under the impression. But I guess that wasn't it. So let me write this down. I gotta put this down for my notes. And McDonald's drive-thru. So I'm just like, what the hell? I really thought that's what it was. But anyway, let's go on to the next topic. It says, studies Gen Z millennials driving the Great Resignation. I gotta read what this is. It says, youngsters workers report being the most dissatisfied with their work life. And I can understand because, you know, you're underpaid. You're doing all these hours for these companies. And they're not paying you anything. You know, they expect you to live off $15 an hour when you got rent. Rent is like the most highest thing right now. You have rent. You have utilities. After utilities, then you have your car note, if you have one. You have car insurance, okay? I forgot to put food in between there somewhere. You got food. So it's like, I can understand the generation can complain because they're not paying people enough to work these jobs. Like, they want you to work like a fucking slave while you're not. We know this is a 100-year anniversary reset. We do know that because every 100 years there's a pandemic. So we know this is a great reset for everything. So let me read and tell you how the young Generation Z feels. Workers are quitting their jobs in record numbers, with the figure approaching 3.9 million in July, a hair shy of the record set in April in what has come to be known as the Great Resignation. But a new global studies of 505,000 workers and small business leaders finds the mass exodus of is being driven mainly by members of Generation Z, those who have spent the least time in the workforce, and millennials. The studies by software and data analyst company Adobe found that more than half of Gen Z respondents report planning to seek a new job within the next year. The generation also report being least satisfied with jobs, 59% with their work-life balance at 56%. Nearly two-thirds of them, 62%, said they felt most pressured to work during office hours, even though they said they do their best work outside of the normal hours. So, I mean, I'm just gonna put young millennials. Dissatisfied with work. I'm sorry, y'all. I usually have this wrote down already before I start my videos, but I didn't today. I just because I'm late doing this video, so excuse me. Okay, on to the next topic. Next topic is not that. We're gonna talk about sports. It says, oh, you know, I want to talk about the one about Cam Newton. Where's that one at? I seen that one. I have that one. Where's that one? Because I thought that was interesting that they dropped him. They saying it wasn't because of vaccine, but I'm just like, that don't even. Maybe this is it. Is this it? Okay, no, that's not it. I have to find it. I don't even know where it is. Okay, well, we're just gonna read this topic. It says, beacon of hope for whole regions, power restored to more than New Orleans, Entergy says. Well, before I read, I'm glad that they're getting their power back because it's, you know, and I'm also hearing and seeing on Instagram that, you know, they're having trouble with getting gas. You know, they have to travel very far to get gas. So I'm hoping that the state of Louisiana get back to some normalcy pretty soon. My thoughts and universal prayers go out to them. Like I said, I really would like to be over there actually helping, honestly, because like I said, I didn't help before with Hurricane Katrina. So I really would like to be hands-on involved over there if I was able to. But we're gonna read. It says, a bright light in dark times was a welcome relief for parts of New Orleans. Some power began flowing to New Orleans East late Tuesday night at about 8:30 a.m. Wednesday, Entergy's power outage map shows areas of Treme and Mid-City had power near North Broad Avenue. Entergy official says as of 12 p.m., about 769,000 customers without power. The president of CEO Entergy in New Orleans said that as of 9:59 a.m. Wednesday, power has been restored to 11,500 customers, and the number is increasing steadily. She said that the first customers whose powers were restored, including houses in the Little Woods neighborhood, as well as the critical care customers such as the Veterans Affairs Hospital and the New Orleans Fire Department. Rodriguez said that this is the first step in restoring power not only to New Orleans, but to the metro region and neighborhood parishes. In the coming days and over the weekend, you are going to see a lot of progress. Each day, we will be able to add more info, more folks, Rodriguez said, the person said. I be trying not to say these people's names that's in these articles because, you know, I don't want nobody thinking I'm plagiarizing or whatever like that. So I just try to read the names on what I see. I'm trying not to read the names on who said it or paraphrased it or whatever. I really want to find that one with Cam Newton. I can't believe I can't find it because I really wanted to read that. I just thought it was an interesting. Let me see if I can go in my mail and see if it's there. Let me check because I really want to read that. I could have sworn I sent that to myself because I just thought it was very interesting that Cam Newton was not able to play on a football team because they said it wasn't because of his vax. It wasn't because of that, but we already know that's a lie. And I don't watch football. I just was re looking at that, and I thought that was a very interesting topic to look at. I can't find it. That is so interesting. Now I don't even see it. I could have sworn I had it. Okay, let me look one more other place, and then I'm gonna go over to my next topic. Let me see. Oh, you know what? I can Google Cam Newton. Here it go. Let me see. Okay, here it is. Was about Cam Newton. Okay, here it is. This is where I read. It says, okay, this is the one for Cam Newton. Once again, I'm writing it down. Okay, it says New England Patriots coach Bill Belichick says Cam Newton's vaccination status had no factor in release, which I'm calling bull. I'm calling bull. I'm calling bull. Foxborough, Massachusetts, New England Patriots coach Bill Belichick said Cam Newton's vaccination status was not a factor in the team's decision to release him. No, look, you guys keep talking about that, Belichick told reporters Wednesday morning. I would just point out that I don't know what the number is, but the number of players, coaches, and staff members that have been infected by COVID in this training camp who have been vaccinated is a pretty high number. So I wouldn't lose sight of that. NFL previously announced that 68 players and staff tested positive for COVID-19 out of 7,190 tested individuals during a 3-week stretch from August 1st to the 21st. The rate of the positive tests amongst unvaccinated NFL personnel was 7 times higher than the rate of positive amongst vaccinated personnel, according to the league. Now, I don't believe that. I believe if we flip the numbers around, because everybody that's getting this shot is seeming to be getting sick. So I don't believe that. I really don't. Newton was away from the Patriots for 5 days last week due to what the team called a COVID-19 protocol misunderstanding. He missed 3 practices over the stretch, which allowed rookie Mac Jones to take control of the team. That's fucked up. The Patriots had disclosed that Newton had undergone delaying tests at the time, all of which were negative. According to NFLPA protocols, Tier 1 and Tier 2 individuals, including all players, are exempt from daily testing if they have received the COVID-19 vaccine. Newton had never confirmed his vaccination status, saying it was personal. I mean, I feel as though you shouldn't have to. I mean, they taking this whole vaccine thing out of proportion. Like you, I hope if they do cut him, I hope he gets a abundance of blessings coming his way, because that is some bullshit. I'm calling bullshit. I don't watch football, but reading this article, I'm calling bullshit on it. I believe that's what it was, because everybody that had the vaccination, they got sick, and then they're flipping it, saying it's unvaccinated people that are making people sick who are vaccinated. I just don't believe that. I remember a long time ago when I was pregnant, I got the flu shot. Like I was peer pressured into getting that flu shot when I was pregnant with my first oldest daughter. Right after I got that fucking flu shot, I immediately got fucking sick. And I vowed to never again to take another flu shot. I don't give a fuck what type. I vowed to never take another shot because I shouldn't have got sick. I thought it was preventing me from getting sick, keeping me and my child healthy. And it fucking didn't. It didn't. It didn't. It didn't keep me from being sick. I ended up getting sick anyway. I didn't know. And see, now that I know what I know now, I would never get another shot. So, I mean, like I said, I hope abundance of blessings come Cam Newton's way, and I hope that they beg him to where he even when he get all these blessings, I hope that they beg him to come back and he decline them. Because you got to look at it, when you have good a bit given God given universal given a bit talented abilities, they're gonna need you. I'm gonna take Baby for instance. I feel like Baby should have said no. He said what he said. People say stuff like that every day, all day. freaking out. I'm tripping. People say things like whatever the baby said all day, but y'all want to take away his endorsements. I feel like the baby should have said, fuck y'all. And I want somebody to cut my endorsements and beg for me to come back. Because, baby, I'm going to show you better than I could tell you, okay? But I'm going to read a little bit more. It says, on Tuesday, Jaguars coach Urban Meyer said he and general manager Trent Baalak took a player's vaccination status into consideration during final roster cuts. Meyer said that it was considered because of the more stringent COVID-19 protocols imposed on the unvaccinated players who tested positive or are identified as high-risk close contacts as compared with the protocols for vaccinated players. Meyer's comments did not go over well with me, the NFL Players Associate. I don't know his name, so I'm not going to say it. It's J and A as initials. The Assistant Executive Director of Internal Affairs for the NFLPA told ESPN via email that Meyer's statements have led us to an open investigation. And I hope Cam Newton gets some money on that ass, because that's some bullshit if you ask me. But what do I know? I'm just a bystander looking on the outside. On the outside looking in, as if you want to call it. Let's go to another topic. I'm not going to read that. Let's go back to my emails. Hold on one second, you guys. I'm going to read another topic, and then we're going to close this segment out. I try to make my videos at least 20 minutes or under, because I know people don't have that long of attention span. Not saying that in a bad, negative way. I'm just saying, you know, some people, you know, 20 minutes is really not that bad compared to like an hour, you know. But anyway, what's another one I was going to look? Okay, we're going to talk about the universal planets. It says Mercury is no longer the closest astronomical body to the sun. Scientists just discovered our star's newest neighbor. Let's see what that new star is. The new star is, as astronomers using a new telescope in Chile have found the fastest orbiting asteroid so far, and it's getting closer to the sun than even the planet Mercury. Although its orbit of the sun is at 113 days longer than Mercury's 88 days, asteroid 2021 PH27 has an elliptical and high inclined orbit that crosses the orbits of both Venus and Mercury. 2021 PH27 is about a kilometer in diameter and gets to within 12 million miles, 20 million kilometers of the sun, where it reaches almost 900 degrees Fahrenheit, 500 degrees Celsius. That's hot enough to melt lead. Give me 1 second. Hello, brother. How you doing? I'm making a video right now, but I could still talk to you. I'm about to end it in a minute, so can you just bear with me? Just stay on the phone? Okay. Well, that concludes on today's episode of The Shit You Missed Today, and I'm going to get off. Don't laugh at me. I'm going to get off and talk to my brother. Okay, before I get off, bro, I got to ask you a question. You hear about Cam Newton, they cutting Cam Newton? Huh? Did you hear about them cutting Cam Newton because he didn't show his proof of vaccination card?
I know something to that.
Yeah. What's your take on it?
It's a business thing.
I feel like it's a business thing, but I think it's stupid. You cutting him because he didn't want to show his vaccination card. That's retarded. I mean, I don't know nothing about football, but I feel like that's some BS. And then they put that new dude, gave that new dude his job. I just read it. Jake or Jane. It started with a J. They just gave Cam Newton job to some other dude, but he white. Oh, that's what he said? He's made a video about that, or he said that in a press conference?
He said that in his post.
Oh, okay. Well, I didn't know because I don't follow him on Instagram. I'm reading these little notes that I have made. But hold on for 1 second. Okay, you guys, that's today's segment on the shit you missed today. Check me out next time. If you like this video, like and subscribe. If you don't, like and subscribe. Leave a comment below. And now I gotta go. Peace.